are wanting to play as far as mobilization and I can't talk and do all that at the same time, so that's just keeping me so long. As far as mobilization and technology. So I'm going to log in here to my eLearn. I'll put all my links in here. So my name is I have a master course. I was just doing something else. Because one of the things that we are wanting to do in the library is not to just be a building over there. And sometimes if you're an English teacher, you might bring your students over there. We do an orientation, or we might show up in your class and say, hey, we're the librarians. If you didn't know what we do, we do library stuff. And so we actually want to be integrated into your courses in a lot of different ways. So I've used a web tool called Smart here to make a flyer. So this is a tool that you all can use as well for your classes. So one of the things is the library is not just information where we are, a lot of technology. So the first thing that we can do for you is to embed ourselves into your classes as a resource. When I say resource, I'm going to show you what I mean here. So I've made a PowTin. This is my first one. So I'm sorry if the timing is off or anything. So I've been playing around with these tools as well, so that the library can, when we are incorporated into your courses or being used for instructional purposes, that it's not, and this is database one, and this is database two. I'm going to click and search, because that's boring, and the students don't really relate to that anymore. They know how to search. So we are going to be kind of upping the ante in the library as far as our role. So is the volume on here? It should play really well. It's just a little song on the background. It's not fancy. So, okay. This is talking about an embedded librarian.
Another topic and used it in her math 1530 by using one web tool that you can transfer to another web tool. Use those free apps. You see that she's putting inside Elon. So the students can come back to it and they can watch it on their phone. They can watch it while they're at the doctor's office. They can watch it while they're not driving down the interstate 81, I hope. Not married now. But you see those people. They can come back to it over and over again. It could be about any content. And let me say a little thing about it. Do you know anybody in this room who has asked you to be an embedded librarian?
Maybe Dr. White.
So, in my RLDP COP2 class, the students have to use the library. That is an outcome, a student learning outcome of the course. So I'm not going to just throw in the databases and the articles like Upload Pro in another course. So they have to learn how to use the library. So I asked Julie, would you be okay to be embedded? So I say to the students, you do not ask me a question about the library. That is not my role as an English professor. My role as an English professor is to talk about writing and this and that and the other thing. You have a question about the library, you ask the librarian. You go to the class list, you see the names, and over here are the roles. Some people are students, some people are instructors, and some people have the role of the librarian. You ask the librarian. So we might come to the class this spring. What were the questions that those students had?
So some students did not know how to access the databases. I walked them through the steps of that. Once I helped the individual student, I just went ahead and created kind of a PDF to upload into eLearn so that students could step-by-step accessing a specific type of article. I also had a student who could not access the databases because of firewalls, and the database was being used by Dr. YROGP was a Tennessee Electronic Library resource, which means it's free to all Tennessee citizens with a different link. So I was able to reroute them to a different database because of basically things that I, you know, that we learn in the library. So rerouting students that way. I did have an unrelated question, and I just pointed them to Dr. White about an assignment.
Which I'm happy to answer, but I'm not going to answer the question about the library. That is not my role as an instructor. You ask the librarian's job. That's why I embedded the library in my class. Now, whose classes can you be embedded in?
So I can be embedded in anyone's. And so here is what that will look like. We are kind of going more with the title of research coach because, let's face it, librarian, research coach. If you're a student, you're not going to use the librarian. You're going to use a research coach. And that is stolen straight from Union University, who presented at TLA and allowed us to steal it. This is what this looks like when you embed me into your course. This is basically I tell what I can do. And then, don't worry, I do not help them with writing. I send them to the writing lab. We don't edit papers, proofread. We don't do the research for them or do their citations. But we point them to the right places and assist them. So I can help them online. I can also schedule appointments, and this is what we're going for. We have this capability. This is Union University, but we have the capability to create this sort of same looking. Well, it's not going. Okay. What it is just where students can make appointments with a research coach. Another thing is an embedded librarian that I can do. Many of you are familiar with, we put some databases into your e-learns that are exactly about your topic. So if you're teaching science, you don't have a history database. And we have 72 databases. Students don't know what to do when they see that whole list.